Hey, what's up, guys? It's Acid Glow here. So we're gonna have a look at Fulgor from the first and second game and compare his special moves and how they've changed and kind of get an idea of what he might be like in the third game. So in the first game, he had the dashing cyber claw thing, which was charge based. So you had to hold back for 2 seconds, push forward and kick. It was the main opener special move that a lot of Fulgor players used. He also had the eye laser. It was a fallback kind of special move that you can use if you were caught in a situation where you didn't have enough time to charge for his cyber dash claw move. Now, the eye laser was okay, but it wasn't quick enough a lot of situations. So I found myself using a manual hit and then going into an eye laser and then going into an ender. He also had an uppercut, triple fireballs, and even a deflector. So he had all the tools to play a distance game. So in the second game, he still had the triple fireballs, but it cost him 1 meter to lock onto the opponent first. And he still had a deflector, which had slightly different inputs, but it was pretty much the same thing as in the first game. So it was pretty much used to just deflect fireballs back at the opponent. And you can use that as a distance or keep away character in some way. Now, he also had the eye laser come back in the second game, but he had two versions. He had the medium punch version, which was meant for close range, and it was a linker. And the fierce punch version was for long range. Now, another neat feature was if you wanted to use one bar of meter, you could do his eye laser in the air, or you can even cancel it after an uppercut. So it gave him more options. Now his cyber dash claw move, which was his main opener in the first game, did make a return in the second game. However, the inputs were changed for this once again. It was no longer charge based, so it was just motion based. So the new inputs were down back, down, down forward, and kick. So it gave him the chance to be a little bit more aggressive. His teleport in the second game actually was not that useful because the fact that it cost one bar of meter to use. And a lot of players that I played with back in the day just never really used it because they felt, you know, why waste one bar of meter for that? The mix-up really wasn't worth it. They also gave him an invisibility in the second game. So it was just half circle back and fierce kick. And as you see, you can only see him when he moves or does an attack or when he crouches. And you can even do combos while you're invisible, but it drained your super meter really quickly as you're moving forward and doing attacks and combos. It really wasn't worth it, so I felt that was kind of a useless special move. Although I'm sure some people were able to make good use of it, I just never liked using super meter for that. So if we combine all the special moves he had in the past, we can look at his eye laser as a way to poke someone from full screen. He had a very good uppercut for anti-air. He also had a deflector to bring back your fireballs towards you, and he can even follow them up with his own triple fireballs. He also had the cyber dash to cover some ground, even a teleport as a mix-up game. So I find this character had a lot of tools for probably a distance or keep away related character, similar to how Glacius plays, but with different special moves. So if he does come in the next game, I have a feeling he would be in a design of a keep away character. So let me know your predictions on Fulgor in the comments section. Thanks for watching, guys. This is Acid Glow, and I'll see you guys later. I'm out.